My name is Amr Mashali, and I'm going to be with you throughout the video series about the D-Dare challenge. But before diving into the challenge, I would like to give you first an introduction about myself. I studied pharmacy in order to change the world into a better place, and I received my bachelor degree in 2016. But 7 years ago, I got introduced to the concept of entrepreneurship, and diving deep into it, I found out that I can still change the world doing entrepreneurship. And since that time, I've been working on developing my skills to become the better entrepreneur I've always wanted to be. And this journey has taken me to 5 different countries, working and living there. And I've also started 3 companies. The journey has not been easy, but it's very fulfilling. You get to learn new things every day. And trust me when I say, Z-Dare is a great opportunity for you at such a young age to get such exposure and to get to acquire such skills that are definitely going to help you to change the world, hopefully one day, and are going to make your career way better. Z-Dare came to life as at the universities of Canada and Egypt, they believe that empowering students through innovation is an integral part of their values. The university sees that every single one of the Egyptian youth has a great potential to change the community we live in into a better place. After witnessing what the Egyptian youth are capable of doing using entrepreneurship and what the students of the University of Canada have been doing during the last 2 years, the university has decided to launch this program in order to utilize the capacity and the potential that you guys have in order to be able to impact the current coronavirus crisis that we are all facing to make it better and change it more into the positive. So now, let's dig deeper to understand more about the coronavirus crisis. And the first lesson you need to remember, as an entrepreneur, in order to find a solution, you need to first understand the challenge and the problem very well. To start with analyzing the problem, it's very important to categorize the different challenges that we are facing in order to understand how to tackle each one. So I divided them into 3 different categories that we can use. The first thing is economical turbulences. The second thing is psychological and societal problems. And the third thing is healthcare system challenges. So first, let's start with the economic turbulences. It has been obvious for all of us that the global economy has been suffering during the last couple of months due to the drastic changes happening. For instance, many industries like tourism and oil have been suffering from the decrease in demand, which has led to them losing lots of money. And then they had to fire lots of people working in the industry. And this will create a major challenge later on. On the other hand, some industries have witnessed a massive growth, like the delivery and the telecom industries. Also, some platforms have been getting more traction, like Netflix and online gaming platforms. Second, let's talk about the societal and psychological challenges. During the last couple of months, everything has basically shut down. Gyms, schools, cafes, malls, everything. This has led to behavior change. Everyone now is trying to do what they used to do, but in a different way. People are working out at home, buying more online products to use for their workouts. People are baking, shooting videos at home, trying to create more interactive stuff to interact with the outside world. There are also more serious challenges, like the increasing rate of domestic violence against children and women in different parts of the world, especially in Europe. And other countries like China has witnessed the highest rate of divorce in its history. Governments are trying to offer different solutions like online consulting and connecting people at homes with psychiatrists. However, with the overwhelming number of people needing this service at this time, it's really challenging. It shows us that our infrastructure is not ready for such a crisis. The last category, and probably the most critical one, is the healthcare system. So what everyone is trying to do right now is to make sure that our global healthcare system does not collapse. What does this mean? Think about it. If so many people at the same time get infected, that means the hospitals will not be able to accommodate them. And this will lead to a definite crisis, which we don't want to happen. So what's next? We want you to come up with an idea that can solve a challenge. What if you don't have an idea? Don't worry, we got you covered. I will be working with you during the next series of videos to make sure that you understand how to come up with an idea that you can turn into a sustainable, profitable business in the future. And now it's time to work. You can start working on an idea by your own or make a team with someone else. If you do so, please make sure to maintain the safety of yourself and people around you. It's time to dig deep into the entrepreneurship world, come up with an idea, turn it to business. See you next video.